Henry and the Ghost Train, written by Christopher Audrey and narrated by me, Dennis Solano. A fair had come to the island of Stodol. Men had set up stalls and rides near the junction. A notice on one of them said it was a ghost train.
"What is a ghost train?" Daisy asked her driver.
"It is a tunnel that trains run through," he explained, "past skeletons and ghosts and other spooky things." Henry was at the next platform. He saw Daisy shiver.
"Pooh," he scoffed. "I'm not scared. Only silly little engines are frightened of ghosts." And he puffed away.
At the big station, everyone was talking about ghosts.
"I'm not scared of stupid old ghosts," Henry said.
But he did not want to meet one. Just a case. That evening, Henry's driver told him, "Part of the tunnel roof has collapsed. The fact controller says we must take some men to clear away the rubble."
"Father," mumbled Henry, "I was looking forward to a rest."
"Cheer up, Henry," said his driver. "Pushing trucks into a tunnel does not sound very much like hard work to me." Still grumbling, Henry pushed two trucks and a van full of workmen into the tunnel. They filled the trucks with rubble, and Henry began to pull them out again. It was going nicely when suddenly there was a loud clanking noise. "Your tender is off the line," said his driver. "We must have run into some rubble. We can't go forward and we can't go back. We shall have to wait until the back controller can sort something out." It was very quiet in the tunnel. The workman walked home and Henry dozed. But he woke up with a start. "He was moving." "Wailed the ghostly voice, and a white shape floated towards him. Henry was terrified. Henry was icy cold and his wheels were shaking, but he hurried on. Suddenly, something strange fluttered in front of him, moaning and groaning. Everywhere, big eyes were staring at him out of the darkness.
"Heep, heep," he whistled loudly. "Help me!"
Then Henry saw a station ahead. He felt much better now. He slowed down to stop, but when he saw what was on the platform, he did not want to. The station had a skeleton staff and a very thin controller. And waiting to catch the train was a vampire. When he heard "oo, oo" in the distance, Henry felt better.
"That sounds like Gordon," he said.
But it was a ghostly, shadowy Gordon who rushed towards him with a scream and a roar. Just as Henry felt he could bear no more, he heard his driver's voice. "Wake up, Henry," the driver said. "Your tender is back on the line. We can go home now." Henry was delighted. He went quickly back to the shed and had a long drink of water. He felt better after that. But he was careful not to tell the other engines about the ghost train. He was sure they would laugh at him